In this video, we are going to discuss about optical isomerism here. Optical isomerism. So, optical isomerism, what I am going to do is, first of all, I am going to discuss about optical activity. Optical activity. Any compound, any organic molecules are there, that compounds are there, they are having optical activity or not. How to identify that one? You are going to take a plain polarized light, you are going to pass through a, what is that, organic compound. When the light is coming here, coming out of this, if it is going this side, either it can go this side or this side. Based on the nature of the organic compound, this plane polarized light can rotate towards left, otherwise towards right, anyone. If it is this compound rotates the light towards left side, means that is, you can say levorotatory, otherwise minus form. Right side means we can show it, this is a dextrorotatory, positive. We can denote like that. It is going as such, in a straight line path it is going, means no rotation here. So that when this compound is optically active, if this compound rotates the light either this side or this side, means then only this is a optically active. Otherwise, no rotation means this compound is optically inactive. So, this is practically okay. How to identify on the paper? By seeing the molecule, by seeing the structure. That one, when it is optical active, I am talking about organic molecule, carbon will be there. Carbon have how many bonds? 4 bonds. Carbon having all our different groups, A, B, C, D. At this end, this is chiral molecule. This molecule is chiral compound, otherwise chiral molecule. Carbon having 4 different groups, that is chiral molecule. This can show the optical activity. Many compounds they are giving. At the time, we have to see the 4 bonds of the carbon, 4 groups attached to the carbon. All the 4 groups are different, means that is having chirality, that can show optical activity. Here also some exceptions are there. They are very less exceptions, very less examples are there. But general concept is, it is showing optical activity, it is having a chiral center. Chiral center means 4 different groups are there, means that is a chiral center, chiral carbon. Now, okay, if this compound, one compound I am taking here, one A compound I am taking here, this light is passing here, this is rotating some 20 degree towards left. Some B compound I am taking, sending plane polarized light, this is rotated in that plane polarized light, right side 20 degrees. At that time, this A and B exactly 20-20. It is a negative rotation, this is a positive rotation. This is a levorotatory, this is a dextrorotatory. Same amount rotating means at that time A and B are called as enantiomers. A and B is called as enantiomers. So how to identify these enantiomers? Exactly 20 degree right side, A molecule 20, B molecule 20, both are having same molecular formula, same degree of unsaturation. At that time, one is A is rotating the plane polarized light towards left side with 20 degree, B is rotating the plane polarized light right side 20 degree. At that time only A and B is called as enantiomers. Enantiomers only differ in their rotation of light. their optical activity only in the rotation of light only they are going to defile. Remaining all the physical and chemical properties are same. And how to identify that enantiomers on the paper? How to identify that one? Here you see, enantiomer means any molecule you can take. I will take glyceraldehyde here. Glyceraldehyde, OH here, H here. Here what I am going to take is CHO, CH2OH, this molecule here. This I am going to keep a mirror here. Mirror here, here. Exactly opposite this OH here. Coming here, H is here, CHO is here, CH2OH here. These two are called enantiomers. If both are having same number of atoms, same molecular formula, same degree of unsaturation, everything is same. This one here I am taking means in the place of A. In case it is this one rotated in the light left side with 20 degree means that must be rotated the plane polarized light towards right side 20 degree. So how to identify? Once you know the one form is other form, you have to keep a mirror here. You have to get a mirror image. What type of mirror image? What is that? Non-superimposable. What is the enantiomer means here? Enantiomer means non-superimposable. Mirror image. Mirror image. Mirror image. See. These two are enantiomers. These two are enantiomers. This is a mirror image of this one. This is a mirror image of this one. And it's not superimposable. I am holding this, I am keeping on this means this one is going to coincide. OH is coming on H. H is coming on OH. So that it is not superimposable. So these two are, what you can say, enantiomer. Enantiomers are non-superimposable mirror images. We can take anything. Other one also I can take. Tartaric acid also I can take. COOH, COOH, OH, H, H, OH. For this one more I am writing here. One more what I am writing. H here. Like this. Here. OH. Here. H. COOH. COOH. I am saying these two are enantiomers. How can I say? I am going to take a mirror image. Mirror image. Yeah. Mirror image like this. You twist. Mirror image. So, superimposable or not? Hold it. Keep on this. COH, COH, okay. OH, H. So, they are non-superimposable. These two are enantiomers to each other. In a, this 1 and 2, okay. 1 and 2 are enantiomers to each other. 1, 2 are, what is that? Enantiomers. Other concept is the diastereomers. Diastereomers means, you see, what I am writing is here, COOH, OH here, H here, again here, what is there, H here, OH here. Simple only here, what I am writing here, OH, H, instead of H, OH. These two are called as. This is as it is one only number, as it is one only number. This one is different one, 3. Here 1 and 3, this 1 and 3, same 1 and 3 are diastereomers. Why? See this. This is not a mirror image. Not a mirror image. Once it is not a mirror image, that is called as diastereomer. These two are 1 and 3 are diastereomers. Diastereomers, what I studied now? I studied about optical activity, I studied chiral center, enantiomer, diastereomer, deform and L form. If one enantiomer is deform means, other one will be L form. This L form means, other one will be deform. Small d, small d. So either anyone is, both are opposite, exactly opposite. That type of things are called enantiomers. And we are going to discuss next concept. And the next one is racemic mixture. Racemic mixture. What is this racemic mixture? What is this racemic mixture? Separately, D form is there, L form is there. Other D and L both combinedly is there. Same molecule formula, everything is same. Only they are going to differ in their optical rotation. If some amount is there in that, both D 50% D format, 50% L format is there. Means this is called as racemic mixture. Racemic mixture optically, what I can say is optically inactive. Even though D separately optical active, L separately optical active. Because D format you are saying is it is a four different groups are there, and L format you are saying is four different groups are there. This is individually optical active, this is individually optical active. That is D and L separate. Both are 50% 50% L is called as resonant mixture. Resonant mixture is optically inactive. Why it is optically inactive? Because this 50% of the mixture is rotating the plane polarized light in right side direction. Means this 50% of the mixture rotating the plane polarized light in a left side direction. So due to the external compensations, the net rotation of the light will be zero. So it is optically inactive. If one compound, something react A plus B reacted, both D form and L form is coming in, this is called as racemic mixture. This process called as racemization. Otherwise, I got residue mixture. Residue mixture is there. D and L format is there. Some catalyst I am going to use. Some reactions are happening. Separately, D form you are going to separate plus L form you are going to separate. This process is called as resolution. This process is called as resolution. Resolumization means 50% 50% mixture. 50% D, 50% L mixture is called resolumization. If some reaction happening, this is D form, L form, I mean, that is resumization. And resumization, resumic mixture you are having by using some catalyst, you are separating them into D form and L form. That is called as resolution. Resolution may be physical process or it may be biological process. By you can use a catalyst. This catalyst mostly is a chiral catalyst. In this optical isomerism, we are going to discuss about the D and L configuration and R and S configuration. There are two types of configurations are there. Relative configuration here. What is that? Relative configuration, and other one is absolute configuration here. First I will talk about relative configuration. Relative is name itself relative. We are going to compare with this one. It is not giving a complete information about a compound. These are D format, capital D and capital L we are going to assign. D and L. D format is nothing but enantiomers. Anything we can say. As you know, our simple compound, what is the simple compound? Glyceraldehyde, CHO. And what is that? CH2OH. OH is there and H is there. Here, there are chiral center. This is how many chiral centers are there in this one? Number of chiral centers. How many chiral centers here? Here, only this is the chiral center, carbon. OH, H, CH2, CH2. Four different groups are there. Number of chiral center is 1. The last chiral center in the molecule is this one only. So this one, in this one, groups like OH group, otherwise NH2 group, this type of groups are all right side. Means these are in a right side. Generally these are right side, means that is a D format. Left side means L format. That is what we have to, based on this only we have to assign the D and L configuration. Not only simple one, this one also, this one I am taking. See that OH, H, H, OH. Here, what is there? Here some CHO, some CH2OH. Anything simple. This is a D or L means immediately I have to go for how many chiral centers are there? This is one chiral center, because first group, second group, all this one is third group, this one is fourth group, four different groups are there. This is one chiral center. Again, this is other chiral center. Why? This is one group, this is different group, this is different group, and all this is a different group. So these are the two chiral centers. What is the last chiral center? This is the last chiral center. In this last chiral center, OH is which side? OH is which side? Left side. OH is right side means D. Left side means L. This is the L configuration. And anyway, we can take different formula. For example, the same thing I am giving to you. COOH here, CH2 tartaric acid. OH is there, H is there, H is there, OH is there. I am giving this one. This is the, I given to you, this is the L format. For this one, D format, what I can write? D format will be enantiomer, COOH, and this OH you have to round it, H and H, this H and OH. This. In case they are giving this L format, this will be D. Like that we can write. Who is going to decide? The last chiral center can decide the D and L formats. This is a relative one only. And come here, absolute configuration. Absolute configuration means this is explains about the arrangement of atoms in a three-dimensional way in a particular molecule. Arrangement of atoms. How the atoms are arranging three-dimensionally in a particular molecule. Particular molecule means here organic molecule, mainly carbon will be there. Each carbon tetrahedral, mostly tetrahedral will be there, four sides will be there. Three dimensionally, how the four groups are arranged can be explained by absolute configuration. Here, absolute configuration means R and S configuration. R and S configuration. Here, some rules are there. Here also, which rules again can engold prolong? SIP rules only. E and Z configuration rules you studied. The same rules only we have to apply here. Higher player priority, lower priority we have to use. We have to use at the same time. Higher priority, lower priority, some other points also is there. We are going to discuss now. See here. Always. What I am reading here? Observe carefully. This bond. This wedge bond getting higher priority means, higher priority means, what is that? Right side means R, left side means, right side means going right. R will be like R only. If this one, reverse I am writing, if this one having a lower priority group, this is having a lower priority, that arrow going right side. For example, right side means R, that you have to say as a yes. I will tell you how to write. Okay, I am taking this one. I am going to give the priority here. Priority. What priority is here? This carbon is oxygen, here carbon, here carbon, here hydrogen. So first priority you have to give for what? First priority you have to give for OH. This is the number one priority. One. Next, second priority. This C2H5 I am writing for mechanics. What I am writing? CH2, CH3 I am writing. Okay. Next one. CH2, CH3. Both are carbon, carbon. Two hydrogens, extra hydrogen. And next one is carbon. Second priority, this one. Third priority, this one. Fourth priority, this one. Another point here is, see, higher priority means as such will come. Lower priority, for example, this one group is there. Lower priority means this dotted bond is there. That should get a lower priority. At that time, the direction is right side means R is like a R only. If this line getting higher priority means, in case your direction is right side means, R you have to say as a yes. I am telling here. See, what is the higher priority OH? There is no wedge bond, no dot bond here. Leave it out. Come here. Lower priority group, what is it? Lower priority group, hydrogen getting which bond? Dotted bond. Lower priority, dotted bond getting means, in case direction right side coming means R only, left side coming means L only. See that? Always you have to go, how to give the direction? 1 to 2, 2 to 3. Here, where is 1? 1 to 2. 1 to 2, like this, 1 to 2, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. I should not go like this, 1 to 2, like this. 1 to 2, 2 to 3. Which direction? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? What is that? This is the clockwise. This will be anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise means RSR. RSR? Yes. Yes. So that lower priority group hydrogen is with a dotted line. I got a S1, so no need of changing S is like S only. In case I got R means R is like a R only. See that dotted line with low priority. Right, in case right side means R is like R only. In case left side means S is like S only. And here, this combo, come here again. Priority, what is the priority? First priority. These two, what is the priority? This is the priority. Last one, final one. Again, okay. Lower priority group containing, what is that? Dotted bond. So I got a right side clockwise means R is like a R only. If it is anti-clockwise means S is like a S only. Why? Lowest priority group present with the, attached with the dotted bond. Okay, I am going to search now. 1, what is my 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3. 1, 2, 2. Not like this. 1, 2, 2. 1, 2, 2. 2, 2, 3. Right side? Clockwise, anti-clockwise. Clockwise. Clockwise is R, S, R. R. So that, it is okay. Lower priority group present with a dotted bond. So R is as such R. That is what? Lower priority group with dotted bond. Right side means clockwise direction is R means R. In case anti-clockwise direction is S only. That's what. Here you see other molecule. Come here again, you are going to give a preference here. What is first priority? OH plus 1. Second priority. Here, I just leave it. Carbon, carbon. All the hydrogens are there. All of hydrogen only, anyone, oxygen. So, all this part, first group, second group, third group, fourth group, for this carbon, first group, second group, third group, fourth group, all this, first priority, all this group will get a which priority? Second priority, this side. Now, obviously, this will be third one, this will be fourth one. Okay, very good. Least priority with a dotted line, highest priority with a wedge line. So if you are getting a clockwise means R as such. If you are getting a anti-clockwise, yes as such. I'm going to find out now. R 1 2 2 2 3, no, 1 2 2 2 2 3. What is this direction? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? Anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise means yes, you have to change R or not? No need of change, because according to rule, higher priority group with the wedge bond. Right side coming means R is like R only. Left side coming means S is like S only. Here I got anti-clockwise, so that S only. Here you come this side. Again, this carbon. This chiral symbol you are going to give the absolute configuration. Here 1. Next one will be, this is bigger one. So the priority will be this big group. 2. Then 3. Then 4. Here also, no need of changing. Because highest priority group getting wedge bond only. So as such, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. 1 to 2, 2 to 3 direction.
three direction. Clockwise, anti-clockwise, clockwise only. Clockwise means as such. R is this part. So here this configuration, S configuration, and this carbon is a R configuration. Like that we have to assign the R and S. These rules are very very important. These two you remember. Any two understanding logically means remaining all we can write. The only thing is highest priority group wedge bond is there means whatever the direction you are getting, same configuration will come. Means wedge bond higher priority means direction clockwise means R is like R only. Direction anti-clockwise means S is like S only. In case highest priority group with dotted line means, in case highest priority group with dotted line means you are getting clockwise direction means you have to say R, but you have to convert that R into S. In case highest priority group, in case lowest priority group with wedge bond means, in case lowest priority group with wedge bond, solid bond means, at that time you are getting a clockwise means you have to say R, but you have to give the configuration as a S. That is what always higher priority will be with a solid bond, wedge bond, at the time as such. Lowest priority group with dotted bond, at the time as such. If these two are not happening, your configuration is going to be reverse to the direction what you are getting by the priority order. Okay, next we are going to talk about R and S in a Fisher projection. Fisher projection we are going to talk.